everyone. This is a tutorial on the Datasmith Direct Link for the improved compatibility between Revit and Twinmotion. Datasmith allows pre-constructed scenes with complex assemblies to be brought into Twinmotion and Unreal regardless of how large, dense, or heavy the scenes are. This differs from the existing Direct Link behind the scenes. With the transition of the Direct Link to Datasmith, it utilizes the existing technology that Unreal Engine has been perfecting. This also means that users will be able to upload multiple Revit files into a single Twinmotion scene. To activate the Direct Link, you will need to have the Datasmith plugin downloaded. You can find this on the Twinmotion website. This plugin is going to differ from the original Twinmotion plugins you may already have. We will be applying this technology to each of the existing software plugins. This means there is more opportunity for growth and improvement for the Direct Link system, such as having multiple Direct Links in one Twinmotion file, as well as properly defining pivot points and editing imported geometry that can later be restored. So let's bring everything together. You'll see that I have two different Revit files open with the Datasmith plugin already installed, one with landscape and one with the building. I'll go ahead and go up to the Datasmith tab here and then select connections. You'll notice that a dialog window pops up saying that there's no connection found. So we need to go into Twinmotion and set that up. I'll go over to the import tab, which is on the left-hand side. It's going to be the top one. I'm going to hit the plus sign here. I'm going to navigate to the import direct link, and I'm going to go to your source, and you'll see that I have both the files here. I'll go ahead and select landscape. And if you are not getting your files here, you'll want to make sure that you indeed press connections in your Revit file. I'll go ahead and hit OK. And I'll do the same thing for the building as well. So now I have the import direct link set up. I'll now need to go back into Revit and synchronize those files. So I'll go over to the left-hand side, go to Datasmith, and I'm going to hit synchronize. Now I'll go and do the same thing for the building, hit synchronize, and then come back into the Twinmotion file. So now both files are in Twinmotion, so let's take a look at the options that we have here. If we go down to the files that we have the direct link imports for, I can click here on the button right above the Revit, and you'll see that there's the direct link settings. So we have the ability to control the way in which the materials are collapsed, whether by keeping the hierarchy of the Revit file, or collapsing by material, or collapsing everything. We'll refer back to this in a moment to understand how this can assist us in our workflow. We also have the ability to reset transformations on selections, as well as materials and re-import deleted objects. So let's test out the materials on this. I'm going to go up to these wood panels here and apply a material to it. So I'll go ahead and select the wood. I'm going to go over to the library, go to materials. I'll pick this wood siding. I'll scale this up and then rotate it to get it in the correct direction. So now that we have this wood applied, say we're working through our file, getting it all built up, and it turns out we actually need to have the material that the Revit file came in with. We can go back to the import window here on the left-hand side by clicking the top button and then going to your Revit file, and you can go in and hit reset materials on selection. And you'll see that it is reverted back to the material from the original Revit file. I'll go ahead and close my library here. And you can do this for transformations as well, whether it's scaling or rotating. You can also re-import deleted objects. So let's take a look at that. Let's say we are removing this planter here and we continue working, and it turns out we do need to get that planter back as a part of the design. We can go to the Revit file. We can click on the button right above and hit re-import deleted objects, and it'll come right back in. Now let's take a deeper look at how it connects with Revit. So I'll pull up the two scenes again. Say we have this column here that we're going to remove in Revit. I'll go ahead and synchronize on the top left-hand side. And you'll notice that in the Twinmotion file, that direct link is starting again, and it's going to remove the column. So now I'm going to close out of these Revit files. and you'll see that the links are broken down here on the Revit files. However, when I open up the same files, that link gets restored. It's similar to device recognizing a Wi-Fi connection. Now let's take a look at the hierarchy of the geometry coming in. You'll see that in the direct link settings, I had selected all of these to come in collapsed by material. So this can be great for applying materials and keeping the organization quite clean, but perhaps you'll want to actually get some of these elements individually. So you'll see that all the trees came in as a plant layer. What I can do is I can go into the landscape file and I can go into direct link settings. And then I'm going to change the way in which the material is collapsed. So here I can go into keep hierarchy. I'll hit OK. And now I can individually select these trees. So this could be helpful for certain tools such as the replace object tool. So I have these trees selected. I can right click here and I can go to replace object. And I'll go ahead and navigate to some trees. I'll drag a few down here. And then I'm going to hit start replacement on the bottom right hand side. You'll see that it brought in the different trees. Hope this further explains why you might choose different hierarchies when you're importing your file. But now that we have both Revit files in, you are all set to start developing your multiple files in this one Twinmotion scene. Hope this improvement will be helpful for you in your workflow. Thanks, everyone.